Hey guys, welcome back. I'm so excited to be doing another nail polish line review today. I'm going to be talking about the OPI Nature Strong Collection. It's their first natural origin nail polish line, and a lot of companies have been coming out with them, so I'm so excited OPI has one as well. They're cruelty-free and vegan. I believe they're nine-free. The cap and the bottle are made of 20% recycled materials. Their formula is 75% natural origin. They also are quick dry and they provide up to 7 days of a nice lasting mani. I also want to say that their brush does feel a little bit more natural, but it works great and it's the same shape as their brush that they have in their regular line. Do kind of wish they would have rounded that brush for this new line. I was really hoping that they would do that, so I'm a little bit bummed about that, but it's a nail polish brush that I'm used to and so it really wasn't too heartbreaking, but it just would have been really nice to have that. So I'm going to be testing these out. I did paint a color on today and I'm going to wear it. I'll probably put a little snippet in here of how long I had that last, or I might just follow up in my story. So follow me on Instagram because I really want to see how long of a wear I can get out of these. I'm pretty impressed so far, especially with the quick dry factor. So I'm really happy about that. Okay, there's 30 shades in this collection. I thought OPI did a really fantastic job of pulling some of their popular colors from their regular OPI line. They're not exact as some of those, but they're really close to some of those, and then some I feel like are really unique to OPI and just unique, you know, compared to ones that I even have in my collection. So we're going to talk about those. I did decide to do comparisons. I decided to do it in one video because I feel like it's just easier to talk about it all at once. These polishes are available at Beyond Polish right now, so go ahead and get them if there's any that you like. Hopefully these comparisons will really help you out in deciding which ones you really want to pick up, and don't forget to use my code GOLARI10 at Beyond Polish for that so you can get a discount, and I appreciate you shopping on my affiliate link. So Beyond Polish has these for $7.99. They're available at Ulta for like $11.50. And so Beyond Polish really does have a great price. And then you get that extra discount on top of that. Okay, so grab a snack and let's talk about all the polishes. The first one we have here is Strong as Shell, and it's a beautiful white cream. It maybe has like a teeny tiny touch of pink. I compared it to Alpine Snow and definitely you can tell it a little bit. I don't know if you're gonna be able to tell that in my pictures, but it just softens that white a little bit. And so I like that. It has a beautiful formula. I got it opaque in two coats on most of my nails. You might have to do three depending on how you apply it, but I really did feel like this had a fantastic formula. Okay, let's talk about those comparisons. First, I compared it to Alpine Snow, and that one has more of a yellow undertone, just slightly. Rydell Forever is straight up white, but it does have that leather-like finish. And then Set Apart by Tile Art is a white with a touch of blue, so I just wanted you to see that. And I'm not sure if you can see that in the pictures there, but hopefully that gives you a good idea. I mean, it's not exact as any of the whites that I had, and a lot of the whites that had pink in them, this one looked completely white. So that's what I liked about this one. It's a softer kind of stark white. The formula is quite opaque, and so it's going to look a little bit stark, but that pink just softens it just a tiny bit. I think this is my favorite white out of all of them. The next one we have is Raindrop Expectations, and it's this beautiful, nice, kind of bright light blue. It's like the lightest you can go before being white. It is a little bit darker than My Boyfriend Scales Wall, which is a white with just a touch of blue, and also Set Apart by Tile Art. So it's a little bit different, you guys. It's kind of in between some of the other light blues that they have. It's a little lighter than those. It's got a great formula. It's a little bit curly, so it's going to take a little bit to build up. I was able to get it opaque in two coats, but you might have to do three depending on how you apply your polish. But I really like curly-ish formulas. Don't get frustrated if you have to do three coats, because I really just think it builds up really nicely. It's just a fresh and clean, bright, light blue. Mexico City Movement is a little bit darker than this, and I didn't do comparisons for that, but I thought I'd have questions about it. So this one's really quite a bit lighter. So I compared it to Essie Virgin Snow. That one's more purple toned and darker, and then Borrowed and Blue is more yellow and slightly darker, and then Find Me Oasis is even more yellow toned. So the thing I liked about this one is it's not as yellow toned. It's more cool toned than those other blues that I have. It's probably my favorite blue now. You're going to be hearing me say that a lot about a lot of these polishes. Then we have It's Ashley OPI, and this is a really beautiful gray. It actually has more taupe than I thought. It's a gray with some taupe mixed in, but not so much taupe that it looks brown. It's just, it's beautiful. I really love this, especially for this time of year. It's got a beautiful formula. I could get it opaque in one coat if you apply it a little bit thicker, and then there were times that I had to do it two coats, but I feel like you can get this in one coat. It almost seemed like it had maybe even a touch of green in it as well. It's just a really unique kind of taupey gray. Okay, so the comparisons. I compared it to Morgan Taylor Let There Be Moonlight. That one's darker and maybe a little bit cooler. I Can Never Head Up is darker but close, but has that green shimmer in it, of course. And I think you can see that it's actually OPI. Actually does have a touch of green when you kind of see it next to this one. And then I can only wear OPI. I wanted you to see how light that is compared to this one. Couldn't find anything close to this. And so this is also one of my favorites. It's beautiful. And then we have Dawn of a New Gray, and they're calling it gray, but this one's definitely more taupe, but it does kind of have a gray feel to it. I'm going to show you the bottle of the close-up of this one and the one I talked about before. It's actually OPI, so you can see those together because this just has a touch more taupe. I guess depending on your color tone, you can kind of see which one of these you might like. I like both. And I think they both look great on my skin tone. I have a medium skin tone. This has a beautiful formula as well. It's going to be opaque in one beautiful coat. I like to do two anyway, but I really could get one out of this one. I did actually make a note in here that I like this better on my warmer skin tone, and so that might help you decide, although I do like that other one as well, but I wrote down that I like this one a little bit better. So that might help you in your decision on which one of these to pick up. For the comparisons, I did Icelanded a bottle of OPI, and that one's a little more taupey. It's more of a brown shade. And then Essie Master Plan is a touch more taupe, but it's very close. And then Essie Take It Outside is lighter and a touch more taupe. So I didn't have any OPIs in my collection that were close to this. I feel like I have a lot of OPIs, but I really don't have a lot of taupe OPIs. And I don't know if that's just because I'm missing some or what. So I felt like this was unique to their line. So this is a great one. This next one is Right as Rain, and this is beautiful. So it's along with these taupe shades, but it has quite a bit of purple added in there. So I love this kind of color, especially for fall. So this is just so beautiful. It's got an amazing formula that's pretty much like the other ones that I just talked about. It's opaque in one beautiful coat, and you'll see that here in my live swatch. It's just really pretty. So I compared this one to Graffiti Sweetie. It's a lighter lavender with a touch of gray though. And then Topaz Beach is more taupe, but not as dark or as purple as this one. But I thought that that would maybe be exactly the same as this one, but it wasn't. Essie Warm and Toasty Turtleneck is more purple toned for sure. So I wanted you to see those. So I don't really have anything, at least in my collection, that was exact as this, but it's really, really beautiful. So these next three, I'm going to do a close-up of all the bottles of these because they're just get gradually a step more pink and a step more kind of corally. So I wanted you to see them all together before I talked about them. But now we're going to start with the lightest one here, and this is a Clay in the Life, and it's a beautiful peach. You guys know how much I love these light peach colors, and there's been quite a few that have come out lately, and this one's really pretty, and it is a little bit different. So this one does have a curlyish formula, and it's meant to be a little bit sheer, and so you're going to take probably 2-3 coats possibly to build up to get that nice opaque finish that you want, or you can leave it a little bit sheer. So that's what kind of sets it apart from some of the other ones, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But the formula is really good. It's a really good Crelly formula. I know I'm going to get people asking me how it compares to Talk to the Sand. So Talk to the Sand here is a little more pink, and it has a more opaque formula. You guys know I love that polish. It was my favorite polish from last year, and it definitely has a more opaque formula. It's the best polish ever, the best peach polish, but I want you to notice how pink it looks next to this one, because this one is definitely more of a true peach, and it's just interesting that it makes it look pink even though that's still kind of a peachy shade. And then I compared it to Let's Be Friends from their 2016 collection. There's an interesting story behind this polish. They brought it back in 2019 because the fans wanted it, and it really was cooler toned and just really not the same polish. I feel like this one is closer to that than the one they came out with in 2019. So if you really liked Let's Be Friends from their 2016 collection, then pick this one up because I think you'll feel like it's pretty close. It has maybe more of a touch, a yellow tone in it, and maybe a little bit lighter, but I felt like it was pretty close. And then Orly Sands of Time is darker and more of an orangey peach. I like them all. So adding a little more pink and a little coral to this one and going a few shades darker, you're going to have this color, and it's called Let Nature Take Its Quartz. And it's a beautiful color. I love these kind of peachy corals. It does have a crelly-ish formula as well. It's going to take 2, maybe 3 coats to build up nicely. So I compared it to We Canyon Do Better, and that's the one I'm going to show you here in a minute. And it's a few shades darker, but in the same color family. And then OPI plus Cute equals Heart. And that one I felt like was pretty close. And then Essie Gel Couture, it builds up a little bit better, and it looks to be almost exact as this one. So I love that Essie Gel Couture polish, but this one's good too. And then we have We Canyon Do Better, and I really like this one because my son's name is Canyon. I told you guys I like nature. I even named my son Canyon. So anyway, I love this one. It's a nice peachy corally shade. It's really pretty. It's got a beautiful formula. It's going to build up nicely in two coats. It's a little more opaque than those other two that we talked about. OPI has a lot of colors that are kind of like this. I didn't find anything exact, but I'm going to show you those comparisons here. So You've Got Nada on Me was actually pretty close. It looks like almost the same color, and the formula on that one's a little bit more opaque than this. Excuse Me, Big Sur was a tiny bit more mauve and a little bit darker, but close. Got Myself in a Jambalaya is brighter and has more pink in it. So there are some that are pretty close. They're just going to be a little bit slightly different. So if you know you love those color tones, you know you're going to be happy that you had it in this line. Then we have Natural Mauve, and I love, love, love shades like this. It's a really cool toned purpley pink shade. It's got a really fantastic formula. It's going to build up really nicely in two coats that you'll see here. I just love these kind of shades, and so I did want to show you these other comparisons that I have. And I didn't really find anything in OPI's line that was exact to this, but I know that Essie has a lot of these shades, and so I'm going to show you those comparisons here. So we have Lavender to Find Courage, and that one's darker and more purple. And then we have That Get Me Not. So that is one of my favorite Essie shades. It's just so beautiful, and it's pretty much the same shade as this. So I'm so happy that OPI has this in their line, and the formula is just so good on this one also. And then Hollywood and Vibe, I knew I'd get questions, and that one's lighter and a little bit more pink. And so there you can see the differences there. So if you love That Get Me Not from Essie and you want to try it in this line, this is the one to get. It's such a beautiful color tone. This next one is Make My Daisy, and I love that name so much. It's a beautiful bright yellow. I love that they have a bright yellow in this collection. It's a little cooler toned. It's not warm and golden, which I really, really like. So it's more of a bright kind of summery yellow, which are my favorites if I'm going to wear yellow. The formula is pretty good on this one. Of course, you guys know with yellow, it's always going to take maybe three coats to build up, and this one's no exception. It's going to be like 2 to 3 coats depending on your application. I would say more likely 3. So on the camera, it's going to show up a little bit brighter. These yellows always kind of mess with my camera, but I wanted to compare to Don't Tell a Soul. This is basically the same polish, and I really like that one a lot. So if you liked that one and you want to try it in the Nature Strong line, then this is the one to get. And I Just Can't Copacabana, that's a little more rich yellow. And then Exotic Birds Do Not Tweet is an even darker yellow. There are the comparisons there. Definitely OPI has a lot of these kind of bright yellow shades, but they must be popular because of course they're adding one to this line, and I'm happy that they are. This next one is Enflowered, and I really love that name. It's so cute. I love these kind of purpley pinks. If you've been following me for a while, you know that I just love them so, so much. The formula on this one is just fantastic. You're going to get it opaque in one, possibly two, but I really was, it's like so close to one coat. I'm going to tell you why I love this polish so much. If you've also been following me for a long time, you know that I love Orly Frolic. It's a polish that's been discontinued for a while, and it was actually hard to find. And I know last year a lot of you went hunting to go find it. And then I actually did a giveaway because I found some bottles of it and gave a few away. And this one is so close to that, you guys. So it makes me so happy. You need to pick this one up. It's like, you would think it would be unique, but it's really not. It's really hard to find a polish that's like this exact color tone. It just has the perfect amount of purple added to the pink. So I'm going to show that in the picture here. You can see it, and it's close. I mean, Orly Frolic might be much more purple, but it's like the closest I have been able to find. Okay, and then Arigato from Tokyo is more purple, and then Two Timing the Zones is a little more pink and a tad darker. So you can see that this one, just the purple sets it apart. It's just, oh, it's so good. I would get this one. This next one is Cactus What You Preach. It's a beautiful, bright, evenly balanced green of green and blue turquoise shade. It's so perfect, you guys. Do you remember a few videos back when I said I'm still trying to find my most perfect shade of turquoise? I really think I found it, you guys. It's an amazing polish with an amazing formula. It's going to be opaque in 1 to 2 coats. It just builds up so nicely, you guys. It's so good. This one has a little bit of a brightness to it, and that's what I love about it. I wanted a turquoise that had some brightness to it, and this one has just enough white in it to make it pretty bright. I compared it to Closer Than You Might Believe, and that one's more blue, and you can see that that's definitely more muted. And Bustling Bazaar from Essie is a deeper color and a little bit more green. And then I wanted to see how it compared to Orly Vintage, and that one's more of a green tone, and that one is really fantastic too. But I like that this OPI one is a little bit more blue toned because I wanted a more blue instead of green tone. So this is perfect. I'm so glad that. I finally found it. It'll probably be the polish that I put on next because I just want to wear it before summer's over. Next we have Spring Into Action, and this one is just so beautiful too. It's this beautiful purple lavender shade, and it's just got a brightness to it, and I don't think that brightness really comes across in the camera. You'll just really have to see it for yourself in person. It's so pretty. It's almost as bright as that one that I just showed you, and it's just so beautiful and quite unique, you guys. This one is a really fantastic one too. It's really special. So I'm going to share you those comparisons here so you guys can see that. So Don't Toot My Flute is more muted purple, but it's also cool tones that you see here. And then Galleria Vittorio Violet, I'm probably saying that wrong, but I thought I'd try the accent to make it better. That one's darker and has a little bit of shimmer. And then I really wanted to compare it to Essie Playdate. You guys, that should have been included in my favorite summer polishes. I took it out and I was like, dang, that's a really good polish, you guys. And it's different than this one. That one has more red in it and it's different. So this one, it's just really special. I really have nothing like this. A lot of the bright purples like this have a lot of pink in them, and this is just a beautiful purple. It's so good. So these next two that I have, I'm going to show you a comparison of them side by side. One is a little more pink tone and one is a little bit more brown tone, but they're both these nice mauve shades and they're fairly close. So one's like cool toned and one's warm toned. So that'll help you in deciding. The first one we're going to talk about is the more pink leaning one. So this is Knowledge is Flower. It's a beautiful mauvey pink shade. There's a lot of colors like this that are popular. There's a lot of different ones in OPI's line. I don't believe I found anything that was exact to this one, but the formula on this one is really great. It's going to be opaque in 1 to 2 coats. I can keep saying that about a lot of these because they're really consistent with their formulas, but I really liked this one quite a bit. It's very rosy and beautiful. So I compared it to For What It's Earth, and that's the one from this OPI Nature Strong collection that's a little darker and more brown but close. And then I really wanted to compare it to Angora Cardi, and that one's more purple. And then Susie Calls the Paparazzi is lighter pink and more of a rosy shade. So there wasn't anything that I found that was exact, and I kept going through and looking at stuff, and this one I feel like it's a little bit darker than some that they have that are of this color tone, and so this one is kind of a little bit. And then we have For What It's Earth, and this one it has a little bit more of that earthy undertone. It's going to be a little bit more brown. This one has a fantastic formula. It's going to be opaque in 1 to 2 coats, and I believe I'm just going to show you one here. And I really love this kind of shades. I think I like this one a little bit better, at least with my skin tone. I kind of like the warmer ones at times. I compared it to Morgan Taylor Be Free, and that one's the closest. It's a little bit lighter. Essie Sorrento Yourself, as you can see, and Suit and Tie. I just wanted you to see the different tones of those. They're all just slightly different, but they are pretty close. I don't have any OPIs, like I said, that are close to this one because I feel like all of theirs are a few shades lighter. There might be something out there that I don't have. As far as my collection goes, I didn't have any OPIs that I wanted to show like exactly next to this. So this one's really pretty. And then we have Big Bloom Energy, and this is a really beautiful bright pink polish shade. It's very coral leaning though, which I think sets it apart from some of the other ones that you've seen released lately. It's not like a cool toned bright pink. It's not neon, but it's bright, but it definitely leans more coral and not as coral as some of the other ones that OPI has a lot of. It's going to build up in 2 coats, and let's talk about those comparisons here. I compared it to Guava Mama because I wanted you guys to see that that one is definitely neon and more pink, and this one has more coral. And then No Shade Here was close, but a little darker and a touch more red. And then OPI, She's a Bad Mufaletta, and that is more of a red coral. So I feel like it's pretty unique to OPI, and it's really a beautiful bright shade, and it's just, I love it so much. You probably need this one too. This next one we have here is a Great Fig World, and it's this beautiful purple shade. It doesn't have as much red as some of the other purples that I have. It's a little bit cooler tone, so it leans just slightly blue, and it's got a really nice formula. I think I did 1 coat for the live swatch and maybe 2 coats for the swatch picture, but the formula is just really fantastic on this one. So Mariachi Makes My Day is very close. A Great Fig World is maybe slightly cooler, but they were almost exact. This one is just a little bit cooler. And then Nice Set of Pipes is deeper and more blue, but kind of close. And then OPI Hello Pretty is more purple. So it was slightly different. So I guess that's why I say there's not anything like it, because it is slightly different. If you love a purple shade and you want to try it, a darker purple, this is the one. So I guess you just get this one. But anyway, hopefully those comparisons are helpful for you. Then we have Force of Nature, and I love these kind of shades, especially for fall. It's so beautiful. It's like a darker gray blue. This one's a little bit muted, which I really, really like this. The formula is fantastic. It's going to be opaque in one beautiful coat. So here are the comparisons that I'm going to talk to you about. So we have Less is Norse. I really thought it would just be exact as that, but it's actually ever slightly more gray, which is kind of nice to not have it be exact. And then we have Midnight Sleigh Ride, which is more purple, but it's kind of the same idea. And then Susie and the Arctic Fox is darker and more purple. I really thought I would have people ask how close those guys were. Really, it's almost exact as Less is Norse. You're not really going to be able to tell that difference. I can tell that difference under my bright light just because I like to know just how different they are, but I really liked this one a lot. It's perfect. And then Shore is Something is next, and of course they had to add one of these nice blues. I love these kind of shades, and I'm really glad that they added one in their line. The formula on this is great, just like they always are with OPI. It's going to be amazing opaqueness in one coat. I compared it to my pal Joey, and that's probably the closest. Mikasa S Blue Casa is just a touch darker, and then Tyler Art to Warm Your Heart is a little bit lighter and maybe a little bit warmer. But really, I mean, there's a lot of these colors like this, but of course they had to add one to this line, so it might be one you might want to get. And then we have Once in Floral, and of course they had to add like a red corally color to their collection because that's what OPI does best, and of course they're going to add one, and they're some of my favorite shades to wear. This one does have a beautiful formula, and it's also maybe a touch more red, and then We Seafood and Eat It is more pink, so it seems a bit brighter than the other ones that I'm talking about, and I don't know if that's going to show up in the picture, but this is really beautiful. You can't go wrong with a bright coral, especially if it's from OPI. And then we have All Hail Queen Mother Earth, and this is a beautiful teal polish. It's a blue leaning teal, which I really love. Obviously OPI has a lot of teals like this, but every line definitely needs the teal polish. It's one of my favorite colors to wear, especially in the fall, but I also don't mind wearing teal in the summer either. Basically any time of year, it's such a great color. This has a really great formula. This is going to be opaque in 1 to 2 coats. I believe I got it opaque in 1. The formula is just really fantastic. That's sounding really repetitive, but all of these formulas are really great. Okay, so let's talk about those comparisons. I compared it to Drama at La Scala, and if we're being super picky, it's maybe a touch darker, but obviously it's very, very close. And then CIA equals Color is Awesome is darker, and then My Studio's on Spring, which is new for the fall collection for OPI, is more green, and I definitely wanted to put that one in there so you could see the difference between a green and a blue leaning teal. So those are both really pretty. I love that new one from the fall line. Okay, so obviously not super unique, but it's great to have this kind of polish in their line. Next we have Give a Garnet, and this is a beautiful pumpkin spice shade. It's a little bit muted. The formula is really, really nice. This is going to build up in one coat, I believe. I did do 2 coats for the swatch picture, but this is just so beautiful. I love these type of colors for fall. Of course, there are a lot of companies coming out with shades like this, but it's because everybody loves them, especially this time of year. Compared to other polishes like this, you can almost see that has a touch of raspberry, like a berry tone to it, which sounds kind of weird, and I'm not sure if that's gonna really show up in the pictures. Hopefully it will. But you can see that as you compare it. So it is just slightly different from those other ones that I have, but I'm going to show you that here now. So Bedrock and Roll is the closest, and that's more of a brownish red. And then Como Se Llama is more of a richer, darker shade. Take Time and Unwind is more brown, and it's darker. While there are a lot of shades close to this, this one is maybe slightly different, which is really nice. I didn't find anything that was super, super exact. So I'll definitely be wearing this one this fall. Then we have Eco Maniac. And this is a beautiful kind of wine leaning purple, but it's a little bit muted. So a lot of these kind of wine shades that are still a little bit purple, they tend to have more of a richness quality to them. This one's more muted, so it has just a little bit of white in it. And so it's just really pretty. The formula on this one is really, really great. This is going to be one coater, and it's just going to go on so nicely. Again, I compared it to Yes My Condor Can Do, and that's a little more rich and a touch more red, and you can kind of see what I'm saying about the richness. I really thought it would be exact as Wild Abandon, which was one of my favorite polishes from the Orly release in fall last year, and that one's a touch more red. I mean, they're kind of close, but that one's definitely a touch more red than this one. So this one leans a little bit cooler and more purple. And then Essie Making Harmony is a more muted purple. So it is a little bit different, even though it's kind of similar. It's just really beautiful shade. And I do think this one stands out as well. Here we have Simply Radishing, and this is really beautiful, you guys. It's like Angora Cardi, but it's more muted and with a little bit more white in it, and it's just a little bit softer than that. OPI doesn't really have any that are exact as this. This is the one I have on my nails right now. So it's kind of like a purple mauve that's a little bit more muted. Now, the formula on this one is really great. It's gonna be a one coat wonder. It's gonna be opaque in one coat. It just goes on like a dream. I like to do two thinner coats on some of these one coat wonders, though, just because I feel like they last on the nail a little bit if you do two thin coats than if you do like a really thick, heavy one coat. Just keep that in mind. But let's talk about this comparison. So I compared it to Morgan Taylor from Dusk Till Dawn, and that one's closest. Not as much purple as this one. And then Angora Cardi is richer in color and even more raisin. And then Aurora Borealis, and that one's more berry colored. So this one is different than anything that OPI has, and I really, really enjoyed it. I think it's good for fall. I think it's also a great transition color. And then we have Thistle Make You Bloom. It's this really beautiful magenta purple with this iridescent shimmer running through it, and it has just a little bit of metallic quality to it, not a lot. I think the ones that OPI have maybe a little bit more, but the formula is really great on this one. There are a few companies that are coming out with polishes like this recently, and I knew you'd want to see some certain comparisons, so I'll have those in a second. But this is going to build up in probably, I would say, two coats. It doesn't look streaky. That shimmer in there is just really beautiful. It makes it glow within, and I'm really enjoying these kind of shimmery shades that aren't like super glittery. So I compared it to Sleepover Squad because I thought for sure you'd want to see that. So that one's lighter, but close. It has more of an iridescent finish to it. This Thistle Make You Bloom is not as iridescent as some of these other ones. And then All Your Dreams and Vending Machines by OPI, that one is more metallic. And then Clash of Tartans, I just wanted you to see that one too. Out of all the ones I'm showing here on my hand, and probably all the ones that are really close to this one's definitely my favorite. And then we have Achieve Grapeness, and it's kind of along that same line as that pink one, but this is the purple one. And it has this gold iridescent shimmer running underneath there. Tiny bit of metallic quality just because of the iridescence, but it's a really beautiful polish. And I love that it's a little bit more of a cool toned purple. It builds up super, super nicely in two beautiful coats, and it's got a beautiful shimmer running through there that doesn't leave any streakiness behind. So of all the comparisons that I'm going to show you right now, this one is lighter and more cool toned than those others, but I just thought I'd put them on there so you could see. I'll let you look at them. I have Samurai Breaks the Nail, The Sound of Vibrance, and Don't You Just Love OPI, and they're all a little bit different, so I do think this one is a standout in this collection as well. This next one is Intentions Are Rose Gold, and it's a beautiful rose gold shimmery shade. They've been coming out with a lot of these lately, and I really am loving this formula, this like beautiful holographic shimmer, you guys. They're perfect for the holidays too, and of course they had to add one in this line. Out of all the colors, I think this is the one I would prefer, so I'm really happy that they added it. It's got a great formula. It's going to build up in one coat, but honestly, I feel like you get a little more depth when you add two coats. I compared it to Worth a Pretty Penny, and that one is almost exact. I feel like this new one is a tiny bit more silvery, but you're not going to really be able to tell that in my picture, but they're pretty much exact. So if you love that one, you're going to love this one from the new line. And of course I compared it to OPI Metallic Composition, and that one's more glittery and a little more silvery. That one is beautiful too from the new fall line. Made It to the Seventh Hill, that one is more metallic and more kind of an iridescent shade with kind of a sheer formula. I love this one. I'm glad that they have it. Next we have Raising Your Voice, and this one is so beautiful. OPI has a lot of shades like this, but I feel like this one's just a little bit unique. It has this nice kind of golden shimmer running through there that's kind of shifty, and then it has these just like sporadic glitter pieces that just make it so beautiful. And in the light on your finger, they, as you move it around, you can kind of spot them here and there on your nail. And so I find that to be really, really cool, and I feel like that's what sets it apart from other polishes like this, because we all know that OPI has a ton like this. The formula is really great though, and like I said before, I mean, you can probably get it opaque in one coat, but building up that second coat really adds a different dimension to it, and so I really loved this one. It'll be perfect for the holiday season. Also, a lot of the ones I compared it to kind of have more of a raspberry finish, and this one is more of a wine. There could have been like 10 that I compared it to, but I just chose a handful that I thought were pretty close. So I compared it to I'm Not Really a Waitress, and that one's close. A Little Guilt Under the Kilt, you will see that here, and then Sending You Holiday Hugs, and those all have different kind of colors, tones to them. I really love that this one has kind of a wine raspberry. So this one is really beautiful and I can't wait to wear it at Christmas time. And then we have a Bloom with a View, and this is a beautiful raspberry red. Those are some of my favorite reds to wear, are the raspberry leaning ones. It's definitely not a straight up raspberry, but it definitely has a touch of raspberry. It's got a beautiful finish to it. It's a little bit curly, so it is going to take a few coats to build up. Probably two, possibly three, but I would say two. But it just is yummy and squishy and perfect. It's like my favorite type of red. Perfect holiday or summer red. I did not do any comparisons to this. I was going to just throw some on there to compare it, but I didn't because you guys know I hate doing comparisons for red because they're all kind of close. They're just slightly different, and it's really even hard to tell in the picture. So it's just a raspberry leaning red. So if you know you like kind of those kind of shades, I know you're going to be happy with this. I think it would look good on anyone's skin tone. So this is just so beautiful. And then we have Onyx Skies, and this one is a beautiful black polish. It's got a nice rich formula. It's a little bit thicker, not too thick. It's like the perfect thickness to get one opaque coat of black, which is what I really, really love. It's so beautiful, and the formula is perfect for this one. I'm glad they added a black and a white, and I just think they did a good job with their color variations. So this one really is beautiful. I love this black. It might be my new favorite black polish. I'll definitely be wearing it this fall and winter because I loved it. Okay, so that's it for all the polishes in the collection. I am so happy with it. They're so stunning and beautiful. It's going to be really hard for me to pick favorites. I think I'll just kind of pick the ones that I feel like are pretty unique. And if I was trying this collection out for the first time, these are the ones that I would for sure want to pick up. So let me show you those. Oh, these are so pretty together, you guys. Should I go through them all, or is this video long enough? Oh my gosh. I'm gonna go through them all. So we've got Raindrop Expectations, which is the blue. This beautiful turquoise, which is called Cactus What You Preach. And then I really loved the more taupey gray, which is Dawn of a New Gray. And then I really loved this purple, Spring Into Action. I really love this Natural Movement. I really loved Enflowered, of course, because that's like my frolic dupe almost. It's a little bit lighter, but super close. And then Simply Radishing. And then Force of Nature. And then the white I really love, Strong Michelle. I really did love this peach, which is A Clay in the Light, Eco Mania. I love all of them, actually. I think these other ones are maybe more dupable. These are the ones to me that really stand out. Oh, I'm gonna add this pink Big Bloom Energy. So many good ones. So what are your thoughts about this line? Do you think you're gonna try any? Let me know down below. I'd love to know which ones you think you're gonna try out. Maybe pick one or two and try them out. Or if you really love OPI and you just are gung-ho, then I don't know, pick out a handful. I think they're really great. Again, they're available at Beyond Polish, and don't forget to use my coupon code, and don't forget to like and subscribe. And thanks so much for sticking around if you're still here, because this video is so long, but I appreciate it. We'll talk to you guys later. Bye.